Represented by the head of service, Dr. Louis Mandamo, the governor was accompanied by the president of EYN, Reverend Joel Stephen Billy, Archbishop of LCCN, Philibus Musa Panti, State Camp Chairman, Most Reverend Stephen Dami Mamza, among others, as he officially commissioned the financial establishment.
I commission this edifice in the name of the Father,
Amen.
The Son,
Amen.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This bank, by the special grace of God, has come to stay. But for it to survive, to be sustainable, all of our faces here, we need to cure it by ensuring we contribute our own quota so that we sustain the bank and it grows and it will have branches.
The giant stride of the church was in line with the increasing demands of the financial services among the people of the state and the country at large. This Brethren Microfinance Bank is now a potential avenue to extend financial services to the excluded people without access to such services and thereby reduces poverty.
Build the house, the builders labor in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, the guard stands watching in vain.
The bank is therefore out to deliver efficient and affordable financial services, focused on promoting the creation and development of flourishing enterprise businesses and generation of employment to the productive poor in the society for sustainable livelihood.
Today, the Brethren Microfinance Bank is making history by joining in the quest by hundreds and thousands of other microfinance institutions to provide a platform, an avenue for people to pursue the unique goal of making money doing good.
As for our esteemed prospective customers, let me assure you that this bank is indeed poised to provide you with excellent microfinance services.
While congratulating the church for job well done, the development is said to make available the financial services to the those states of the rural communities. Its vision is to be a dynamic and financially sustainable financial institution, delivering holistic social and economic transformation and empowerment of the active communities it seeks to serve. Hilde Jesse Eliaduma, Twisis News.